it's more organized. It's, you know, it's there's you know, the quality of the visitors is more pronounced. You know, they were happy with the breakfast seminar that we held this morning. They were happy with the presentations we made. And South African visitors that we'd invited were happy with the quality of the presentation in terms of having given them an insight on the opportunities that exist. Our exhibitors here have, you know, said, look, it's an eye opener to see, look, there's a Big Seven a trade show going on outside, so maybe next year we must be more versatile and we present our products so that we can get more buyers interested in coming to our booths. But they've been very, very appreciative of the quality and numbers of exhibitors, visitors at the exhibition and the presentations, and just the quality and appreciation in terms of admin of the trade show.
But with one currency for Africa, assist Botswana or not?
One currency.
It's a challenge. It would be a challenge. I think probably it can work when we brought our countries to almost a comparable level of stability. Because you know that the currency depends, you know, to a large extent on the stability and therefore the demand of a particular currency of a country. So, for example, in Botswana, if we were not following what we call the crawling peg system, the pula would be the pound of Africa.
Right.
But we've had to intervene and not let it run away, to the detriment of our economy. But at the end of the day, we want to export, and therefore we don't want our goods to be priced out. So we're having to apply the brakes to align with the rand and the special drawing rights currencies. But otherwise, our currency could have been the pound of Africa.
Maybe just to also take it a bit further, it's probably not a currency issue as much as it is a trade issue. So let's say we have the Southern African Customs Union at the moment, which has five countries that are members: Botswana, South Africa, Lesotho, Namibia, and Swaziland. And that's the oldest customs union in the world. But it allows, you know, for freer access to trade and for us to trade and export and collaborate easier. And the SADC, wider SADC countries of 15, I think eventually we'd like to have a system whereby we can open up the market so that this actually seems or acts as one economy.
Mm-hmm.
So it makes it easier to, you know, to even have an input from South Africa to, you know, to Botswana or from Tanzania or to Botswana, and then sort of, you know. So the ideally the currency is not as important, I think, as the trading environment.
Yeah.
And we're looking at expanding that even to East Africa as well. And having sort of a tripartite agreement where you have East Africa and Southern Africa having a common sort of a trade bloc.
Mm-hmm.
And similar to, I suppose, what the EU is doing. So ideally, you currency maybe is one step, but it's not necessarily the most important step. I think the most important step is to make sure that the region as a whole can trade amongst each other. So I think in the EU they've got the euro, but I don't think it's necessarily was the first. I think it was the last steps. So, you know, you first try and get everything in order, get the economy sort of working at around the same level as he mentioned, and then I think eventually we can talk about things like that. But I think we are far from a common currency.
Thank you.